greatest irony in America's war on terror. The alleged link between Al-Qaeda and Iraq, which was used to justify the war. We've obtained the US military's secret logs of the war and occupation in Iraq. They give a totally new insight into the conflict and its aftermath.
Deadly chaos in the heart of Baghdad. A man with a mobile phone filmed the second blast.
Concerns about a new wave of terrorism. Local police say they arrested two members of Al-Qaeda after another car bomb was intercepted.
Scores were dead and dying after two massive suicide bombs.
The secret files reveal the greatest irony in America's war on terror. The reported link between Al-Qaeda, the terrorist group behind the 9/11 attacks on the World Trade Center, and Iraq. And yet again, the files expose the difference between what leaders say in public and what was happening on the ground.
Iraq today harbors a deadly terrorist network headed by Abu Musab al-Zarqawi, an associate and collaborator of Osama bin Laden and his Al-Qaeda lieutenants. Iraqi officials deny accusations of ties with Al-Qaeda. These denials are simply not credible.
But the files show that when the American army invaded, they quickly discovered a different story. We looked for references to Al-Qaeda in Iraq from the earliest days of the occupation. In 2004, there are only 7 brief mentions of the terrorist organization, and no suggestion that they had killed anyone. By 2008, however, there were more than 8,000 entries. That's 1 in 7 of all the significant activity reports being filed. And Al-Qaeda in Iraq was linked to the deaths of 45 coalition soldiers, almost 500 members of the Iraqi security services, and nearly 1,300 civilians.
Al-Qaeda in Iraq has been created as a consequence of the American invasion of Iraq. The Americans tried to break it in 2007-08, and as American troops are now drawing down, Al-Qaeda is reconstituting as a major cause of death and suffering in Iraq.
Al-Qaeda in Iraq grew stronger by exploiting the Iraqis' discontent with the Americans, caused by civilian casualties, the Abu Ghraib scandal, and the divisive political system.
The United States and allies came believing that Iraqi society by its nature is divided along sectarian lines. And therefore they felt that the political system that they were going to encourage, to establish, would have to reflect these sectarian differences.
Al-Qaeda in Iraq was able to take advantage of the situation to deadly effect.
وكان العراق أقرب إلى الهاوية في 2006 بسبب هذا التناحر الطائفي وعندما هدأت هذه الموجة الطائفية لتقوتها الأحزاب نفسها.
Our analysis of the data shows that Petraeus's 2007 surge did have an effect on members of Al-Qaeda in Iraq. But the reports noted that while significant numbers of Al-Qaeda in Iraq were being killed, there were plenty more to replace them.
Intelligence assessment. We have seen multiple sensitive reports indicating that a surge of suicide bombers and car bombs, foreign fighters, especially Saudi, have recently been placed into positions of power with Al-Qaeda direct action cells. There's little to keep the hardcore foreign fighters from continuing to conduct these types of attacks.
In 2008, this video was seized by US soldiers in a raid. It purports to show that Al-Qaeda in Iraq was training Iraqi children in terrorism. That's a claim supported by some of the reports in the secret files. We've uncovered 10 suicide bombings involving children as young as 11. According to the reports, Al-Qaeda in Iraq's child squads were called the Hummingbird Cell, birds of heaven and youth of paradise. The Americans identified why youngsters were attracted to Al-Qaeda in Iraq.
Children are coerced into the organization by the lure of money or presence and a sense of belonging.
One report describes an Al-Qaeda grenade attack on a U.S. military police unit.
300th Military Police Company reported seeing two males approximately 13 years old conduct the attack on their patrol. MPs did not engage the two males.
But Al-Qaeda in Iraq weren't just recruiting the very young. The reports suggest they found an even more vulnerable group. In February 2008, in a pet market in Baghdad, two female suicide bombers killed 72 and wounded a further 147.
It is believed that the suicide bomber was unwitting and appears to have been handicapped.
One secret report reveals a raid on this mental hospital days after that bombing to arrest a doctor.
Intelligence assessment. Detainee allegedly received an specified payment to provide a list of female patients to them. These females were likely used in the 1st of February dual suicide attack on local markets.
But the most devastating attacks by Al-Qaeda in Iraq were large scale.
Two blast sites, one at Baghdad Provincial Council, one at the Ministry of Justice. 61 killed and 252 wounded.
That report is one of the last contained in the American Army files. From October 2009, they started to draw down and ship troops home, leaving Iraqis in control of their own security. The United States Department of Defense told dispatchers that it deplored WikiLeaks for their actions in sharing secret information with the world, which they said endangered troops. They stated,
"We strongly condemn the unauthorized disclosure of classified information and will not comment on these leaked documents, other than to note that significant activities reports are initial, raw observations by tactical units. They are essentially snapshots of events, both tragic and mundane, and do not tell the whole story."
Today in Baghdad, the Sunnis and Shias are separated by huge walls, and the violence continues.
لم يقضى على القاعدة. الآن العنف سوف يصاعد أكثر فأكثر.
These graves at the Najaf Cemetery have only one word on them. It's Majul, the Arabic for unknown, and their numbers are growing.
Today, in 2010, Iraq is still a very violent, very unstable place. Averagely about 500 people a month, innocent civilians are being murdered. Violence, extrajudicial violence by the state, torture is commonplace. The political elite are resented and seen as profoundly corrupt. This is a dreadful place to live.
Military historians will take years to properly analyze all the information in the secret files, which chronicle the detail of war as never before. Others have already delivered their verdict.
The United States has paid a huge price to put the future of Iraq in the hands of its people. We've persevered because of a belief we share with the Iraqi people, a belief that out of the ashes of war, a new beginning could be born in this cradle of civilization.
I'm a democracy, Egyptian. أحلى ديمقراطية يعني. خليتونا نعيش بكابوس مرعب من الديمقراطية.
How can you not feel sorry about people who have died? I mean, you would be inhuman if you didn't think that. But when I'm asked whether I regret the decision, you know, I have to say I take responsibility for it, but I can't regret the decision.